In January of 2009, we were asked to create a documentary about Barack Obama's rise to the presidency. The following documentary tells the story through our eyes and in our own words.
In the halls, in between periods, there's a lot of people in the hallways. It takes them about maybe 20 minutes into class period time to clear the hallways because kids are out talking. They're probably here just to see their friends or just for somewhere to go or because their mother told them they had to come to school. But for me, it was just like, this is where I wanted to be because I know where I want to go. And I know to be able to get there, I had to do pretty much my best.
And then some students are affiliated with neighborhood gangs. We come to school hoping that, you know, the next fight that we have doesn't include any weapons to harm anybody watching.
The most helpful part is that the teachers help you, they motivate you, and they support you in everything. They don't give up on you. They always tell you to try your best. You never give up.
Getting to know you.
Hi, my name is Lynne Luswenyo. I'm 17 years old and a junior at Coolidge Senior High School in Washington, D.C. I am a dedicated and loyal person. People depend on me to do various types of things.
Hey, my name is Michias Zewdu. I'm 17 years old. I'm a senior in Coolidge High School. If I describe myself in one word, just being intelligent.
If I could describe myself in one word, it would just be big.
If I could describe myself in one word, I think it would be well-rounded. Hey, y'all. Hey.
I believe that I am a very smart and successful young woman. And although I am smart and successful, I do make mistakes. And what keeps me going is that I learn from my mistakes to make me a better person.
When Barack Obama first announced his candidacy for the presidency of the United States, students said they felt skeptical. And who could blame them? Everywhere they turned, people said it couldn't be done.
I knew it was going to happen. I just didn't know it was going to happen in my time.
No.
Never? Never in a million years? Or?
No.
No.
Never.
Never thought that.
Although many were skeptical about his chances of winning, Barack Obama inspired people in Iowa to vote for him when he made a speech at the Jefferson Jackson dinner before the Iowa caucus.
And because that somebody stood up, a few more stood up, and then a few thousand stood up, and then a few million stood up. And standing up with courage and clear purpose, they somehow managed to change the world.
When Barack Obama won the Iowa caucus, he inspired students to believe that he might be able to win. We knew the dreams could be a reality.
Originally, I was for Hillary Clinton, but then Barack started, you know, he started edging out and getting more and more victories. And like the night of the election, started winning like 90% of certain states and 80%, and I was like, wow, everybody really wants him to be president.
And CNN can now project that Barack Obama, 47 years old, will become the president-elect.
When I saw Obama cross the stage with Michelle after giving his speech on election night, that moment in time really felt like a new beginning, and I could just feel the energy in the air.
Although these students were inspired by Barack Obama's rise to the presidency, they didn't yet know how they could be a part of this movement for change. Then, Principal L. Nelson Burton of Coolidge Senior High School received a call that would change everything. In this call, the president's inaugural committee notified Mr. Burton that Barack Obama was interested in paying Coolidge a visit before his inauguration.
Personally, I was excited about meeting him myself, and I thought that the students would really appreciate getting to meet the president. total of about 400 people participating in the service project, and there were about twice as many standing outside wanting to come in.
He walked into the room. He just lit up everyone's faces. They were like, oh, oh my gosh, Joe Biden. You can't believe he's here.
We could contribute. We would create a documentary to inspire others to heed Obama's call to service.
And with Obama's inauguration right around the corner, we had a lot of inspiration to draw from.
So help you God. So help me God. Congratulations, Mr. President.
Armed with a camera, all five of us began to piece together some footage and then learn from our mistakes.
This is the fallen heroes who lie in Arlington whisper through the ages. We honor them not only because they are the guardians of our liberty, but because they embody the spirit of service, a willingness to find meaning in something greater than themselves.
President is black, my Lambo's blue, and I mean, damn it, my rims ain't.
When Obama came to Coolidge, that made me think, like, you know, a black man could do anything.
Today was a good day, hope I had me a great night. I don't know what you're fishing for, catch your great white. Me, I see great white, heaviest killer whale.
The impact that Obama's visit made on me is that it made me realize that you give back, you get something back in return too.
Me and Mr. Obama encouraged me to just be more in my community and inspired me to actually think that I could be anyone that I wanted to be.
Each of us can make a difference. All of us ought to try.
When Barack Obama came to Coolidge High School, he motivated me, focused on my work and my education.
Somebody else could get involved in tutoring a child.
We need to recruit all this black as my boo. It's really a death storm.
One thing that Barack Obama's example teaches me is that when you're a good leader, you inspire others to better themselves and their work.
Those of us who are not content to settle for the world as it is, can remake the world as it should be, that together we can seek a newer world.
We hope you enjoyed our movie and that you'll walk away feeling inspired to
dream big,
take initiative,
and be the change
you want to see.